Welcome back. In this step, we'll be going over how to add your product costs and inventory levels. Similar to adding new products, we'll be importing this information from spreadsheets. Please note, the steps used to add costs in this video only apply to those using moving average or manual costing. If you're using first in, first out, or last in, first out, or you have products with serial numbers, we'd encourage you to get in touch with the inFlow team to help you import your costs with a purchase order. You can find contact details in this guide. Let's start with importing costs to inFlow. For the CSV template, you can use the product import template from the Adding Inventory video in the Getting Started guide. The only columns you'll need are the product name and cost. When you're done creating your spreadsheet, save it as a CSV file. Now back to inFlow.
In the main menu, hover over Settings, then Import.
In the Data Type drop-down menu, select Product Details. Select the CSV file from your computer, then click Next. On the mapping screen, map the product name and cost drop-down menus. You can ignore all other fields on screen.
Next, click Import.
You'll get an email when the import is complete. If you have other details you want to add to your products in bulk, repeat this process to update those other product fields such as descriptions, custom fields, or remarks. Now, on to starting inventory levels. When creating the import file for stock levels, you'll need two columns, the product name and quantity. You also have the option of adding a location, sublocation, and serial numbers for your products. Now, back to inFlow to import stock levels.
In the main menu, hover over Settings, then Import.
In the Data Type drop-down menu, select Stock Levels. Select the CSV from your computer, then click Next. You can choose how inFlow should handle the quantity levels on the CSV. Because you're adding quantity for the first time, select Set Inventory Levels to what's being imported.
Below, select the adjustment reason. This adds a note as to why you're adjusting the inventory levels. The blue area is where you can see a preview of what inFlow is reading from your CSV file. This section will update with your product information as you select from the drop-down menus below. Match the product name and quantity fields to the matching fields in the drop-down menus. If you don't see the fields below, click on Edit Data Mapping.
Once you've mapped those two fields, click Import. A confirmation message will appear on screen to let you know that your import is in progress. Once the import is complete, you or the team member who started the import will get an email with the results. From here, you can look at your products and see that both the costs and the starting inventory levels have been added to inFlow. Up next, we'll go over pricing and taxes.